The AOD 9604 is phenomenal because it does work on the growth hormone pathways, but it also it opens up some metabolic processes that allow patients to really shift over into burning fat as an energy source instead of the sugar. So it makes your fat more metabolically active. So the white fat turns to brown fat. So there's five major categories. So joint health, I mean, that's BPC-157. You can use the thymosin beta 4, also known as TB500. And that creates very selectivity in the stem cells. It also is a great way to heal tissues.
Okay.
And the thymosin gene is the very first one that's activated when you get a cut or when you have an injury. So you know, it activates this healing response. So it's a very powerful peptide. The third category is where we look at more of the immune category. So the things where we've got the infections, and that category is fascinating because if you think about you know, some of the things that can go on with autoimmunity. I mean, we talked a little bit about, you know, the coronavirus and how devastating that is. But if you think about some of these lingering, like Epstein-Barr viruses, Lyme disease, these things can completely disrupt somebody's life, even mold toxicity. So, so some of the peptides we use for mold toxicity would be, you know, once you clear Marcons and do some of the underlying foundational work for these patients, we'll use like the vasoactive intestinal peptide that Dr. Richie Shoemaker help formulate and discover. We'll use LL37, and that's you know, that's a natural secretome from your stem cells, and that helps eradicate any kind of biofilm. So LL37 is a great one. We use the BPC-157 to get rid of some of the glyphosate and some of the toxins, because this is, you know, it's a human gastric secretion is where the BPC-157 comes from.
Yeah.
So that, you know, these are some of the immune modulatory peptides that we found to be very effective and incredibly safe, along with the thymosin alpha 1, which is a universal peptide that almost anyone can use. Then we got diabetes and diabetes is what I call this module and these peptides. So if you look at weight loss, you know, a lot of people get frustrated because they're like, look, Reagan, I've been trying the keto diet, I've done paleo, I've been vegan, and they've done all these things. And they're like, man, I can't lose the fat. And I feel like crap. And I go on high calorie diet, low calorie. And so this is where we'd use, you know, peptides that are very specific for, you know, these types of patients. And so some of those peptides, this is like AOD 9604. And this is an exciting peptide because it stands for anti-obesity drug. The AOD 9604 is phenomenal because it does work on the growth hormone pathways, but it also it opens up some metabolic processes that allow patients to really shift over into burning fat as an energy source instead of the sugar. So it makes your fat more metabolically active. So the white fat turns to brown fat. And so that's when the mitochondria come to the surface and your body can actually start using that as an energy source.
Sorry for the interruption again. To find out more about this speaker, become a speaker on our show, have Dr. Carter present at your event or podcast, learn more about coaching, consulting, tissue allografts, exosomes, supplements, legal help, or how to create a $1 million business card and dominate your area, we're here to help you. Just text your name and any question to 561-962-1231. Write that down. That's 561-962-1231. Or go to our website at drrosscarter.com to learn more. On with the show.
There's a hormone that HCG that kind of has a similar effect.
Yeah,
is that correct?
Very similar effect. And they've actually done studies So the HCG, one of the problems is, there are side effects, and it can also affect your pituitary, and it can downregulate some of your endocrine function.
Right.
And it can upregulate cortisol, which will end up causing you to put on more weight in the long run.
That's not good.
No, not good at all. But the AOD9604 doesn't have any of those downstream adverse reactions that we've seen.
Oh, that's great.
And so, fascinating. The one caveat on any time you're working on growth hormone, you want to be about 90 minutes away from any food that would cause an insulin spike. So for those of you who are using these peptides, there's the right way to use them and there's the wrong way. So, the wrong way that I see where it doesn't work for people is when they're like, yeah, I'm doing my injections. I'm like, well, when are you doing it? And they're like, well, usually just after dinner. And I'm like, yeah, and you probably had a glass of wine, ate some dessert or whatever. And your blood sugar spikes, which pushes insulin into your blood. And then these peptides don't work. So don't do them unless you're in a more of a fasted state.
Okay. So got it.
Kind of an important note for you doctors out there who are just getting into this. Cause we've went through it. Trust me, we've made all the mistakes. So,
right. That's the advantage here. So that would be the diabetes and weight loss. Was there any other ones in this sector?
Yeah, and then there's a few others, but kind of a one that I love is the 5-amino-1-MQ. And the 5-amino-1-MQ is another one. I know, it's another great name. I mean,
5-amino-1-MQ. That is just a fantastic name.
And this one you can do orally, which our patients, they love it because a lot of these are, injections only. But this one actually helps improve muscle performance. It works on IGF. It also works on the MNT pathway. So that same pathway that activates the AMPK. So it just turns on your mitochondria. So this is another great way of influencing cell-to-cell communication, turning on fat burning, and working directly on that DNA. So that's a fun one. And there's a few others.
Okay.
The D-SIP is, you'll like this name, D-SIP. It sounds like a rapper,
yeah, exactly. Like your
D-SIP
LL one. What was the LL one?
LL 37, and not to be mistaken with LL Cool J.
Correct. That's exactly where I was thinking. All right. Don't want to get those confused. All right.
No, but, going along with the rap theme. Yeah. This is where D-SIP is a deep sleep inducing peptide or delta sleep inducing peptide.
Oh, that's good.
And so this one, just like Epitalin works on your pineal gland. This one does as well. So it regulates circadian rhythms, helps your melatonin secretion, and down regulates that sympathetic nervous response. So D-SIP, our patients dig it. So
and how do you take that? Is that before you go to bed or how's that?
About 45 minutes before you go to bed.
Is it a daily thing or is it you do it non?
Well, the great thing about peptides is it's not like you stop doing them. You know how if you take a supplement, usually it's like, okay, I've metabolized that thing. I pooped out the rest and it's out of my system.
Yep.
You got to keep taking it.
Yep.
Well, peptides stay in your system. They create a different expression. So the cell communication and vibration of the cells, actually there's a continuation for 30 to 60 to 90 days. Some patients, it completely resets things. And so it's not like it's something you have to keep taking. D-SIP, we find that we put a person on it for about 2 weeks and then we can take them off.
And they continue to sleep well.
Continue to sleep well. Yep.
I like it. That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. I like things that work and that actually change the way that your cells, where they're not dependent on me. So it's like, yeah, I'm sleeping great and I don't need D-SIP anymore. So couple cycles and we want them off.
Beautiful. Beautiful. All right. So any in more related to sleep or is that the primary one that you go for on that?
That's the primary one. I mean, anytime someone takes any of the growth hormone type peptides, the anti-aging, they're going to sleep better.